My name is Richard Mwaremangwatu. I'm the managing director, Tavevo Water and Storage Company Limited, from January this year to date. The funding that we've received is 88.6 million shillings in total, of which 77 million has come from the European Union through the Water Sector Trust Fund. In addition to that, we have 11.5 million being the Taita Taveta County government's contribution to the project. We have also received Kenya shillings 128 million, which has come from the WSTF funding for a number of activities.
Number one, let me say, as a county government, we've really tried our best to ensure that the right for Mwananchi to get clean and safe water is achieved. I asked the CEO Water Sector Trust Fund, Mr. Shaye, to help us achieve the same. As we talk here, there's a big project you're doing, the Nyangoro Maktau. The county government contributed 11.5 million into the same. Nyangoro Maktau is a flagship project for us, which is reaching about 17,000 residents, cutting across 3 sublocations and 14 villages. So for us, we really appreciate what Water Sector Trust Fund is doing, and I'm sure upon the completion of the project, many residents will have solutions to these water problems which have been there for several years.
With the funding from the EU through Water Fund, what has been funded, we have had the construction of 3 interquarter springs. We also have 42 water points, 2 water kiosks, and then you also have 20 kilometers pipeline construction in the area. Then we also have 7 kilometers of distribution networks.
So this is Mgambonye spring intake. The spring intake collects water from this point all the way to a collection chamber. So among the project components is 3 springs. We have Mgambonye, we have another one called Kusinyi intake, and we have Mangau. All the 3 springs converge to one collection chamber. And then from now, from the collection chamber, we have a direct transmission line from the collection chamber to Maktau overseer tanks. The height at this point is 1,354 meters above sea level, so that height is enough to allow water to flow through gravity to the last point, that is Maktau. So among the other project components, we have Nyangoro borehole, which supplies water to a tank that is at Nyangoro Hills called Kisokokonyi tank. So the purpose of the borehole is actually to supplement. Whenever there's dry periods, the spring's water level decreases. So we need to supplement that water to the community, to the people. We also have another borehole called Kwandoto under this project. And that Kwandoto borehole, we have constructed an elevated steel tank of 48,000 liters. Also, its purpose is to serve the community living around Kwandoto area and all the way to Komnengwa. So the furthest point at Maktau, that is overseer tanks, we have rehabilitation works of the tanks. And we expect that all this water they're collecting at this point, we take that water to Maktau. So the tank capacity is 2 million liters combined capacity. So we expect that when the tanks are full, it is able to serve the community over a very long period of time, let's say 3 months before they are empty. So basically, the purpose of this project was to serve the farthest person at Maktau with water.
Mimi ni Frank Maganga Mzee. Mimi ni chairman wa Mangao Maktau Water Project. Huu mradi ambao umeanza na bado unaendelea, bado hatujaanza ku benefit. Bado. Lakini venye tunaona tutafaidika. Sababu kitu cha kwanza mimi nitaanza kwa education. Kupitia shule, sasa hivi watoto ninaona ile ilikuwa kurauka asubuhi na kwenda mtoni itapungua. Kitu ya pili itatufanya tufanye shughuli zetu vizuri. Kwa sababu ulikuwa unarauka asubuhi kuanzia 6 mpaka 6 huko kwa maji.
Okay, we anticipate this project to increase potable water access to at least 17,000 people initially, and the number might grow as time goes by. Given that those were areas that were previously not adequately served with water sources.
We want to also thank the Water Sector Trust Fund through SNV program. They were able to train some of the committees, the rural water committees, in running of the other water schemes. Because apart from the Nyangoro Maktau, we also have several rural water schemes. So As a county government, we are committed to train the committees on governance issues.
To ensure sustainability, the project from its concept and onset is actually climate proofed. And then at the same time, there are those management schemes that we plan to put in place to ensure that this investment does not go to waste. The project will be handled in a joint cooperation between the community and Tavevo Water and Sewerage Company, because there are some elements that we cannot take over from the very start, but those ones that are in the, let's say, the relatively urban areas where we don't have issues of pricing, we'll actually handle them from Tavevo's side. And then there are those elements where we'll actually have partnerships with the community, so that even the community feels that there's a benefit being taken to them by virtue of the project being in their area.
As a county government, we own these projects that we do jointly with the partners and the donors. So as we own the projects, that is also part of sustainability. If the donors are here today, I would say a big thank you to them, because it is through them that now the county is able to reach this far. Because if it were not for them, then as a county government, we would be very, very far away reaching the goal of ensuring that Mwananchi has clean and safe water.
Kwa majina yangu najulikana kama Ali Mbuzia Mwachiro, ndio mwenyekiti wa Mwangani Water Association. Malengo yetu ya Mwangani ni kupata maji kwa kila mtu, na maji swafi, maji kwa karibu na uswafi kwa jumla. Kikundi ilianzishwa 2010. Nilipata ujumbe kutoka kwa Kwale County, maofisa kutoka Kwale County, kwamba kuna wafadhili wangetaka kuboresha vikundi vya maji. Ndio tukaitwa kwa semina huko Matuga. Ndio tukaambiwa kwamba tu apply. Tulipo apply tukapata hii ruzuku kutoka kwa Water Fund. Tulipata milioni 13 kutoka Water Sector Trust Fund. Hiyo ruzuku tuliopawa na Water Fund, hiyo ruzuku tulieza kujengewa pipeline ya kilomita 6.5 kilometers. Hiyo pesa ilikuja ikatujengea masonry tank ya 100 cubic. Hiyo pesa ikaja ikatujengea kiosk, water kiosk sita, na tukanunua meters. Tulijenga choo milango sita.
Kwa kila mtungi tunauza shilingi 5. Sheria zenye tunafuata ni sheria zile za kutoka Wasra. Kwa katika hizo kioski tunazo tunapata pesa, kwa sababu wale wanaonunua maji ndio wanaotufanya tunapata pesa. Ni sisi tunatembea pale kwa wale wanaohudumu katika kioski wakiuza maji, tunawasomea mita tujue kwamba ni units ngapi wameuza, halafu sasa tunakusanya zile pesa, ndipo sasa kwa mwezi tunajua kwamba tumepata kiwango hiki, halafu tunachukua tunapeleka kwa account. Kama kuna mambo yote yanafaa kulipwa, kuna ofisi tunalipa, kuna askari mwenye anatulinda kwa ofisi tunamlipa, kuna kibarua mwenye ametufanyia kazi, kwa sababu kuna wakati kuna kuwa na kazi labda mfereji umepasuka. Sasa huwa tunakusanya tunatumia zile pesa.
Changamoto zilikuwa ni mingi. Mwanzo Mwangani ilikuwa hatuna maji, maji yalikuwa haipatikaniwi kwa karibu.
Mimi naitwa Saumu Juma na ni mkazi wa hapa kijiji chetu taitwa Mdune Village. Kitambo ilikuwa tukichota maji kama dakika 10 kutembea, kwenda 10 kurudi 10. Lakini tangu hii project yenu mlete imetusaidia, kwa sababu population ya hapa nyingi sana wanachota hapa. Hii water kioski huwa ina maji wakati mwingi sana kuliko kitambo tulipokuwa haijaletwa huko. Kwa siku nachota mitungi 8 na nalipa shilingi 40. Kutoka kwa nyumba yangu paka hapa kwa kioski natumia dakika 2.
So hapa ndio ni kama main source ya maji, kwa sababu hapa yanafika, hata kwingine huwa hakuna. So tunauza sana maji hapa. Kwa siku kama tutauza vizuri, wakati mwingine kuna magari yanakuja, pikipiki, tunaweza uza kwa siku moja hata kama 2000. Kwa hivyo huu mradi unafaidisha watu, hata si kijiji hii peke yake, hata sehemu za Kilifi. Mtungi mmoja tunauza shilingi 5. Tunalipa water bill watu wa Mwangani. So kila mwezi tukibiliwa, sometimes tunalipa kitu kama 13,000 kwa mwezi mmoja.
My name is Justice Tembo. I work at Mwangani Users Water Users Association as a water technician. I benefited from this program between the Kenya Water Institute and the Water Sector Trust Fund as an intern. Later on, as a water technician, where I was posted into this utility. My daily work are to help the associations in daily operations, maintenance, capacity building, mapping of the infrastructure, reporting, and to support the sustainability of the utility.
Ningependa kushukuru Water Fund, Embassy of Sweden, and Embassy of Finland. Kwa jumla hizo, Mwenyezi Mungu aweze kuwabariki.
Kitamba awali, kabla hii mradi ijekuja, tulikuwa tunachota mto huko, alafu watoto wakienda, visima ilikuwa ile mrefu sana. Kwa watoto wakienda huko, visima na visima, inafunikia watoto ndani.
The real situation before this project was that genuinely the learners were the ones who are helping us to fetch water from the nearby river. That is, it can be three or four times per day, or maybe two times. And that was costing to some level their time. And also, we were not able to access clean water. While fetching water from the river, at times the river may overflow. That means those learners were being risked. Mostly dropped out of school.
Tangu tukipata tukukosa maji, tulichotanga laga. Saa singine tunachota muto, saa singine tunachota laga. Hapa ni mbali, muto ni huko, karibu ya ile milima. Tukuamuka hapa saa nane, tunaingia huko. Kurudi tena, tayari imepiga saa 12 kwa njia tu kitembea.
So kutoka hapo, mbeni kipata wata kaunti, tukadilia juu ya maji, katusaidia kwa upande ya proposal. Hata waga trust fund, kutoka hapo, kapata barua trust fund kwamba watatusaidia maji. Partners ambao walitusaidia. Wa kwanza ni Galida, wa pili Water Sector Trust Fund, wa tatu Turkana County Government, alafu wa nne community. Tulipatiwa pesa milioni 29. Hiyo pesa ilitumika kwa wall, keeping, sanitization. Pipeline ilikuwa 10 kilometers, 50,000. Elevated district tank na kiosk tatu na VIV latrines na cattle trap tano na yet house nne. Murua kwano office. Wakati mradi ilikuja kwa hii kijiji yetu ya Lukoroko, tulikuwa na population 2,400. Na sasa hivi, ile water trust fund alitusaidia maji, tuko na population mingi saa hii, roughly 4,700.
Na saa hii, tumepata maji mpya ya mbereji. Tumeona badili yake, sababu tumekunya maji, malaria mingi imepunguza kidogo kwa ajili tumepata maji mpya. Sababu nyumba ni karibu, maji iko karibu, nikichota ninapeleka ndani ya nyumba kwa haraka kuliko ile ya mto, ambayo yamesaidia hata watoto kwa shule, yamesaidia hata community yote kwa kila kijiji.
Tunashukuru donor ambaye alitusaidia hii maji na wakakawa na watu wa trust fund pamoja na county. Tangu hii maji kuje, imetusaidia sisi sana kwa upande wa magonjwa, kwa upande wa shule, na tena kwa wale watu ambayo walikuwa wameishi mbalimbali na mtu.
The number one Lukorkor Water Sanitation Project has helped this school in many ways. One, we have a yard, a tap, that is there where learners can access that water easily. Then we have the VIP toilet. Then we also have a hand washing facility. We are happy now that we have clean water. We have time. I think what we need to do is now to, all our energies has now gone to this land, at least to change the, to give the quality education and what deserves to this land. We thank God for that also, because we don't have stress enough. The Water Sector Trust Fund, God bless you so much. Danida Group, we appreciate that. The county government of Turkana, wherever you are, you did the best of you. And the community at large, where this school is in.
So right now we are in a village called Loitakori. Loitakori is a village within Kakuma and is falling within Turkana West Sub-County. The main funding for this particular project is from Danida, and it was directed through WSTF, but the project is being implemented by Oxfam through support from the county government. As Oxfam, through the funding, we managed to equip the borehole that you can see over there. So the borehole is being run by the structure, which we've also done under this project. Then we've also equipped the borehole with a submersible pump over there. For every 1 hour, we can get 2,000 liters out of the borehole. Then we've also done a one-kilometer pipeline, which is created using very superior pipe, HDP pipes, running all the way from the borehole all the way up to elevated tower stand, then supplying water to the water kiosk. So another component that we've done for them is the elevated tower stand, which has, it is 5 meter high with a 10,000 liter tank on top of it. Then we also have got a water kiosk that is also constructed, which is fully automated and is supplying water through water ATM.
We are standing on top of Kabogo ATM, which is actually hosting a 250 meter cubic elevated tank that is intended to serve the population of Kakuma town. So this tank of this capacity is serving 5 water kiosks, where each water kiosk has a plastic tank of 5 meter cubic.
Wakati sisi tulikuwa hapo mbeleni, watu hapo Loitakori walikuwa wakiteseka mbaya sana. Lakini kuanzia hii kampuni, wakati kampuni zote zilishikana mikono, wakaamua kutusaidia zi watu ya Loitakori, watu ya Loitakori wamefaidika. Sasa watu wote wanakunywa maji hapa karibu. Sasa ATM kwa saizi inatusaidia zaidi, kwa sababu ya hizi maji, sio maji ya kuenda bure kumwakika. ATM ametuokoa. Wakati mtu anashika ATM, anafungua maji kwa uzuri. Baada kumaliza hiyo maji kupunguka, jirikani yako ikija, maji inajifunga peke yake. Tumeshukuru ile kampuni ambaye ilisimamia mambo ya hiyo, pamoja na hali ya maji yenyewe ya kuchimba maji. Tunafurahia sana na tunawashukuru.
Initially, before we rehabilitated the system, what used to exist was the manual hand pump. That was the Indian Mark II pump. So that was the only source that they had here. So it had got a number of challenges that they were facing. One of them was that it was breaking almost every time. Under this program, what we've done for them is to increase the storage for the water and also ease the access of water, because right now they don't really have to really do it manually, pumping the water to come from the hand pump. But now it's automated. They can now just pump it and it is elevated, then they get it freely now from the water kiosk. The average population for this particular village, because we have this particular village called Loitakori, and some other indirect beneficiaries also coming to get water from the same area. So we can talk about close to 2,000 people benefiting from this particular source, including the schools and the health centers around. The impact of this particular project is that now we've now improved for them the access. They are now able to get water freely with a lot of ease without necessarily pumping it out the way they used to. We've also shortened for them the distance. They don't have now to walk all the way from their villages to come get water. We are at the biosanitation facility that is constructed within Kakuma town. We have got a toilet facility which is inside. mpya, tabi kwa male and female category. We also have the enterprise shops, two of them within the building. We also have a caretaker unit. That is the placement for the person who will be taking care of the whole building. We have an office kind of for him here. Then we have got a kitchenette that is also located in the same center building. So the idea is that we'll be generating methane gas out of the waste that will be generated from this. Then is the methane gas that will be used now to run the facility here, especially in the kitchenette area. So as per the design, it's meant that we'll be getting gas after 10 to 14 weeks from the time they've started using the facility. Plans that we have is that as Oxfam, part of the contract that was given here was to do for them the capacity building on the uses of the facility, which is already done, and all the users, we've already also formed a committee for the local people that will be using this particular committee. We've already trained them and equipped them with the necessary skills to manage and run the facility. Partners involved are WSTF, Oxfam, Danida, county government, and of course the local users, the communities that will be using this facility. As Oxfam, we are really grateful for the support that we've gotten from the donors, and also to the county government for also giving a chance to also implement this thing within Kakuma. And we are really happy and hoping that we'll still get more funds to enable us to expand this kind of facilities in other places also in Kakuma. Yeah, great.